The reason for this volume of the digest is I received a call recently from a friend of mine who had started cutting his hair. And he admitted that he had not cleaned his clippers in 6 months. I cannot underscore the importance of proper sanitation. It's paramount. It's the greatest thing to give you success and the worst thing that will cause your downfall in the barber game. So please pay special attention to the following volume of the Barber's Digest. In this volume of the Barber's Digest, we're going to talk about proper sanitation. You know, a lot of time when you go to the barber shop or when someone cuts your hair, you see them always sweeping, they're spraying their clippers, they're sanitizing their combs, their brushes. You know, they're generally trying to keep the place clean. But let's talk about why they do that. One of the first diseases we're going to talk about is the barber's rash, and the medical term is Staphylococcus aureus, and that's a really infected follicles. One of the main causes of a barber's rash is using unclean shaving equipment as well as reusing dirty towels. And you have to have a prescribed antibiotics to get rid of this type of condition. And it's marked by red itchy skin as well as pus-filled bumps. The next disease we have is called barber's sinus. And it's a penetration of hair fragments into the skin. And what it causes is a condition called the pilonidal cyst. And a lot of places where a pilonidal cyst can begin is in the inner part of the hands as well as on the arms that are uncovered, as well as on any other body part that is uncovered. There's also been situations where barbers throughout the day have neglected to wash their hands, and hair that has been cut has lodged into their follicles, different colored hair. And so out of the same follicle, you have two or three sets of different colored hair that would be growing at one time. So the next disease we have is ringworms or microsporosis. This is caused by fungus that is transmitted by direct contact, either by contaminated equipment or by dirty towels. So direct contact would be contact between the client's hair and the clippers, and then taking that same set of clippers without sterilizing or sanitizing and using on someone else's hair. You can see how contagious that can become after you do a few clients like that. That's something that you really want to watch out for. So here is just a collage of all of the many products that you can use as sanitizers, blade wash, barbicide, cool lube, any one of these things that you want to use. But what's important is that regular daily sanitation is a priority. So here are some tips for sanitation. And the very first tip that I would like to talk about is you want to sanitize all of your implements after every client to ensure that there's no cross-contamination or no foreign bodies being introduced to clients, as well as you want to sterilize all of your tools after every client. And that would involve submerging reusable tools in the barbicide and making sure that those tools are clean for the next use. Also, you want to wear protective clothing, you know, to cover your hands if necessary, as well as your arms. And then too, also, you want to maintain personal hygiene. You want to wash your hands up to your elbows regularly after every client to make sure that none of the hair is being redeposited into your own follicles. Be neat and orderly, because you'll come to find out that people who are neat and orderly usually are clean. And also, the last one, you want to stay stocked and whatever cleaning agents you prefer, make sure they're on hand and make sure they're usable. You have to make sure that everything you use is properly clean, neat and orderly, because it will definitely have an effect on your clients. And you don't want your client coming in and asking you why they have this particular sore or why they have these bumps, and you know deep inside that the reason for that is because you didn't take the time to make sure that all of your tools was in the right condition.